Good morning, students. Today we are going to study the new lesson, Human Eye and Colorful World. So last lecture in light lecture you have in light lesson you have studied about the basic concepts of light, such as reflection of light, scattering of light, refraction of light. Then you have seen how the images form. This different things you have studied. Okay, in this lesson you are going to study the human eye, and you are going to study many different phenomena related to light. Okay, now human eye. Now you all you all use the eye to see the colorful things around us, all the universe, all the nature, whatever you can see, it is seen by our eye. Okay, so what is eye, how it works, all these things you are going to study in today's lecture. Now you can see here, see, this is the diagram of human eye. A session is given. Okay, so you are going to study, this is your front view of your eye and this is the inside view, okay, inner view of the eye, means a section is taken. You are going to study each and every part of the eye. Okay, so we'll start with the outer layer. As you have seen your eyes, okay, how you can see, when you see in the mirror, you can see an outer layer is there, outer covering is there, transparent covering in your eye. Okay, that transparent covering is called the cornea. Okay, the transparent covering which you can see, which protects all the inner part, it is called as cornea. So here you can see this is the outer transparent cover and it is called as cornea. Okay, which protects the eye, inner part of the eye. Now here, see, it is this very simple, all this part, just try to understand very carefully. Now you can see many your friends are there who have different colored eye. Okay, some has black color, mostly everyone has black color, little brownish color, or some people also have blue color eyes. Okay, different color varies. Why the color varies? Why the iris color is different? Okay, it is just a simple thing. It depends upon the muscular part which is present behind the cornea. Okay, behind the cornea there is a muscle, muscular diaphragm, and it depends upon the color of the muscles. Okay, if the muscular color is bluish in color, then the eyesight, means from this transparent layer you can see that the eyes iris is blue in color. It depends upon this muscular diaphragm, the muscles which are present inside the cornea. This gives upon this our color of eye depends. Okay, now you can see here, first one is cornea, it is a front transparent cover. Second is iris. What it is? It is the muscular diaphragm behind the cornea. Okay, behind the cornea you can see here. And what happens over here, you can see after this. Okay, when you see yourself in the mirror, you can see a small spot is there between the our eye, very small spot. You can see that your eye is there, and in between there is a very small spot in between. Okay, iris, between the iris, and you will see the muscular part, it is like this. Okay, so this is the iris, and inside this iris you can see a small hole like shape. Okay, and what it is, it is called the pupil, and this is the muscular diaphragm, this is the muscles, muscular diaphragm, which denotes the color, or which indicates the color of the eye, how the eye should be. It should be brown, black, blue. Okay, and this small part in between, it is called the pupil. Pupil means what? It works as to enter the light through it. Here you can see, this is the iris, and here you can see small opening, you can see in the mirror also. And from this opening, what happens? Light enters through this opening, small opening, and it is called as pupil, P-U-P-I-L. Okay, and from this the light enters to the eye, and behind the pupil, what it is there? You can see the lens, this white color part, it is called as lens. Behind the pupil there is a lens in our eyes. Okay, so where the light enters, it enters through the pupil. Now you can see, pupil means it is small opening of iris, or it is also called as dark center. Okay, because in the center you can see a dark spot, and that is the pupil. And when you see inside, when the light enters into the pupil, it falls on the lens behind the pupil. You can see here, this is the lens which is behind the pupil, and you can see how the lens is fitted over here. It is supported by the muscles. These, you can see this and these two, these are the muscles, and this muscles carry the lens, holds the lens over here, and these muscles are called as ciliary muscles. Okay, the ciliary muscles supports the lens, and it maintain the position means behind the pupil. Okay, when the light, now there is one function of pupil, you know, when you are standing in very high light, okay, means it is very sunny day and you are out of your house, that time what happens, the intensity of light is more and the light falls in your eyes with more intensity, that time what happens, you can see this small hole, the small pupil, what happens, it becomes small, it contracts. Okay, it contracts means it takes only less amount of light into your eye. And if you are in a small intensity light room, means there is very less intensity of light in a room, so that time what happened, this pupil dilates, means it becomes bigger, this spot, you can see the spot becomes bigger and more amount of light is entered to your eye to see the objects. Okay, this is the function of pupil. Means in camera you have seen what were things, you can see how we can adjust the light, how you can adjust the focus of the light, all these things it is in our eye, you can see. Okay, all these things are managed by this pupil. Okay, it is present in the muscular part which is called as iris, in iris. Okay, so iris muscle helps the pupil to contract or dilate. It depends on the intensity of light, how the intensity of light is. Okay, so this part you have understood. Okay, how the light, more amount of light, how it enters to our eyes, and how less amount of light is taken by making this pupil dilate, and more amount of light enters into our eyes. Now, as the light is enter into our eyes, now what things happen behind, inside the eyes, that we are going to see. As you all know that our eyeball is whitish in color behind. This all part you can see it is whitish. It is a muscular part. Okay. So now you have studied about the cornea, transparent membrane. You have studied about the iris. You have studied about the pupil, which helps to focus the light. And now we are going to study about the lens. Okay. Lens, after lens. Now in this lens, what happened? The light falls on the lens and it goes back to the screen, and in light you have studied. Okay, when you are keeping a lens in between, light falls on the lens and it goes back and falls on the screen. Similar setup is there in this. You can see light falls through the lens and it falls behind the screen. Now what is the screen of our eye? It is called as retina. In our eye, if the light enters in this lens, it falls on the screen behind, and you can see all this region, it is called as retina. Okay, so this is also called, it is similar to the screen. Okay, means light falls over here, it reflects, it falls on the screen, and this part it is called as retina. And if you will see this between space, this space is filled with fluid. Okay, and that fluid is called as vitreous humor. Vitreous humor fluid is filled, you can see a vitreous chamber. And this, it is filled with fluid, so that what happened, the light enters into that and falls on the screen. Okay, so here also we have completed eye lens, then retina you have studied. What is retina? It is the inner back surface of the eye, and most important thing, retina is very important. Why? Because retina contains receptor cells. What is receptor cells? You know, in this light receptor cells are present in this retina. There are two types of light receptor cells, one is rod cell, another is cone cell. Okay, this part is very interesting, listen to it. Okay, now what is receptor cell, means when the light falls, now two conditions are there. During daytime you can see everything clearly, during night you cannot see, means if there is no light in a room, in a dark room, you cannot see clearly. Why, what happens over there? So here two types of cells are there, receptor cells are there, cone cell and rod cell. See, cone cell is called colored vision cells, means it promotes the colored vision, and rod cells are called as black and white vision promoters. It promotes the black and white vision. Means what? Now during daytime you can see different, in night also you can see when the light is there, but in dark you cannot see the colorful thing. All things you will see just black color. Okay, this is differentiated by these two cells, rod cell and cone cell. Very important, cone cell is used for the colored vision. Means all the colorful things you can see because of the cone cells. Okay, means during daytime or when the light is there everywhere, when the light is there, that time cone cells are active. Now now in the daytime your cone cells are active. Okay, and in darkness, in night, if there is no any light around you and in darkness you are sitting in the darkness, you can see some blurred vision, you can see the objects, but very lightly. How you can see? Because during that time your rod cells are active. Okay, and because of the rod cell you can see in night. Okay, means you cannot see clearly, but you can at least you can see the outline of any object you can see in darkness. Okay, it depends upon the rod cell. As you know, some animals which are coming out at night. Okay, you know rats and all these things. How they are able to see at night? Because they have large amount of rod cells in their eyes, which are active during the darkness. When there is dark, that time the rod cell get active. So in our eyes also such types of cells are there, but in less amount. Okay, so that's why when we go out, what happens when we are in dark, our rod cells get active and cone cells is not active that time. That's why you cannot see any colorful things in darkness. Understood this concept, cone cell and rod cell? Okay, this is very important. This helps some animals also, those who come out at dark, means at night, for in that animals or birds, you know owls, bats, in these animals what happened, there is large number of rod cells are present in their eyes. You have seen the owl's eyes, it is big and large number of rod cells are there. That's why because of the large eyes, more amount of light can enter into the eyes, means more big vision it can be created because of the rod cell. They have larger amount of rod cells in their eyes, and as they don't have any cone cell, that's why colorful things are not visible to such animals or birds. Okay, this is the main thing for this. So you have studied the retina. Always keep in mind, in retina these receptor cells are there, light receptor cells are there, which are called as rod cell and cone cell. Okay, this thing you have understood till here. Now you can see this. These are the blood vessels which are shown with orange and blue. These are the blood vessels present in your eyes. Now you can see whatever, how you can recognize the thing. If you are seeing this board now, how you are imagining, how you know that whatever you are seeing, that is the board. Means something connection should be there with your brain, okay, which can recognize it. So here you can see from here retina, there is the nerves, which is called as optic nerve, which goes and joins the brain of a human being. Okay, means whatever things you are seeing, that goes through the optic nerve and it reaches to your brain. Means whatever image is formed in the screen, that goes into your brain. Understood here? So that nerve is called as optic nerve. How it takes the signal? Now here images form on the screen, okay, and this image is converted into the electrical signals, and this signal is passed through the brain, and brain recognizes the electrical signals and it tries to convert it into the things or objects in, okay, or identify the objects. This way you can see or you can identify any objects. Now here there is very important part which is called as blind spot. Okay, what is blind spot? Now in all this thing, all the parts which you have studied over here, in the retina and optic nerve, between this two, blind spot and optic nerve, there is a small spot in between which is called as blind spot. What is the function of the blind spot? Actually, as you know, this is very sensitive. Retina is very sensitive, but the blind spot is insensitive. There is no any sensation. It cannot prepare a image also. okay, and as it is present between the retina and optic nerve, in between a spot is there, which is called as blind spot. If the light falls on it, it is insensitive, there is no any image formation, that's why, and you cannot see anything at that point. At some point you cannot see if the light falls on this blind spot, so it is called so the name is given as blind spot. Okay, so all this thing, normal vision, short sight, long sight, you are going to study in next lecture. So this is the structure of the human eye, and working also I have explained, functions I have explained. Read the textbook, okay, and try to understand. If you have any doubt, you can ask.